This is the live virtual Meet Me On Main experience. I'm Adam Grubb, your host tonight. We are on Facebook, YouTube, and Carmel TV. Again, comments on Facebook or YouTube, and we at the end of the evening, we will pick three $100 winners for a gift card. We now move into Susan Brewer. Susan is with us, and she's at the Evan Lurie Gallery. Susan, good evening. How are you?
Hi, Adam. Good. Great.
Good. So we've had art, and then we've had food, and now we're back to art. It is a great night here on the Meet Me on Main experience. Susan, tell me a little bit about where you're at, what you do.
I'm actually one of the artists here. I've done curatorial work here for a couple of years, and then I'm kind of giving you an update of what's coming up next month. So Francisco Valverde, whose work is here, there's a lot of his work coming in from a museum in Fort Wayne, so that'll be the feature for July 2nd Saturday. Beautiful work. He's from Mexico City. As I said, I'm one of the artists. I've got some great work here myself. Some of my favorites.
Oh, yeah.
And then we also have a lot of people in the area would know Jerry Points. There's a lot of his work here. There's the encaustics that he's doing, nice bright colors, some big pieces. And it's beautiful. I wish everybody could be here. The weather is so wonderful. But hopefully next month.
It is a beautiful night. And we hope people could come there very, very soon. Now, tell me a bit about your work specifically. So, and your history in art and kind of how you approach your work.
I am an abstract expressionist. I'm at the Stutz Building downtown for 17 years. I just like the New York School of de Kooning and everyone, I just start. So it's building up layers of texture and color. There's no pre-planning. You know, it's a very impromptu, spontaneous process. And, you know, there's no formula. So all of my work is very different depending on, you know, I say, a recent piece I did, I've been doing a lot of gardening, so it has a very floral, a lot of energy in it, that type of work. So it's really about that moment in time. That's my work. But I love working big. I have some 6-foot canvases going right now, and a lot of work on paper. That's been my past few months, is lots of studio time.
So that studio time is designed specifically for creative expression, or is it designed to finish a project? Where do you go?
Projects going.
Okay, so you're always doing something.
Oh, always, yes. Yeah, but my studio is a hot mess. There's just stuff everywhere.
Yeah, so and some of the other artists that are there and some of the other collections, tell me a little bit about them.
We have a lot of Nick VC. That's the X-ray work in the back. Can we zoom on that? He does the X-ray pieces. And
so we're at the Evan Lurie Gallery here.
Our stable artist here for since the beginning of the gallery 13 years ago. Nick Beasley's work here.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's old school. It's an X-ray. You know,
yeah.
There's probably 1,000 images in here, you know, reducing, layering. It's a very complex process. As they say, nobody's knocking this guy off.
No. Not at all. That is stunning work. Look at that.
That's the Rat Pack series.
So how do they find you, or how do you find these artists? What's the process, and are you always constantly evolving your gallery, moving people in and out? How does that work?
Well, Evan's carried VC and Valverde. You know, it's what he takes to his all the art shows, Art Miami, and all the big shows. But they've always been a staple of the artists here.
Great. So, and you have been there for how long?
I've been represented here since 2013, but working curatorial for 2 years now.
All right. And your day-to-day task as far as curating and working there as executive director, what does that entail? And where do you find the most enjoyment of your job and in your day?
I love promoting art. You know, people come in and they're so intimidated by art, or people start a sentence with, you know, I don't know much about art, you know, and I love kids being, you know, exposed. There's great art here, you know. I'm afraid people have too many flat screens in their home and not enough art. that's it. It's really just, you know, meeting and greeting and meeting people where they're at, you know, and find out what they want to, if they are looking for something or just to expand their awareness about art and why people make art.
So We saw some glimpses of the gallery there. And if you don't mind, Susan, taking us around just a quick tour of some of the other pieces and some of the other areas there, because it's just a beautiful space. Even if we just kind of walk around a little bit so people can get a taste of what that experience is like there.
Yeah, this is Susan Tennant. She's local. This is the sculpture. This vessel piece. This is Robert Berkshire. He was a Heron professor. He left his estate to the school. Then we have Phil O'Malley on the far wall over here. He's a good friend of mine, local artist, abstract as well. Another VC here hanging out, getting ready to hang.
Yeah.
Need help hanging that. Those are heavy.
Now, the space there is creative. It appears to be a very modern gallery, but some of your pieces aren't just modern, correct? I mean, you've got pieces from all different types of art.
Well, it's contemporary fine art. It's definitely a contemporary focus.
Okay. And then is there any – go ahead, sorry.
Oh, Cari?
No, I just – my last question was for you, Susan, was just on the experience of coming into your gallery and – people having questions, people wanting to know more about the art, wanting to know more about the history. Tell me about the staff you have there and how they help people kind of move themselves through the art world. Because as you said, it can be challenging and a little intimidating at times.
And I think another thing that we're doing a lot of here, though, as far as we have a lot, we've been doing pop-ups here, and this is Cari Hahn. And she's been a fixture here on Second Saturdays. So it's been fun to have her here. And I'll let her kind of tell you what she's all about.
Great.
Just come to the gallery, you know. You have to get in front of a painting and have the experience. That's what it's about.
Great. So we have the Karma Candles there. Tell us a little bit about what you've set up there at the pop-up shop.
So what I've been doing is I come in for the Second Saturdays, which obviously this month I can't see you in person, but I'm hoping next month I can see you in person. And it's amazing out today. The weather's amazing. Right now I'm stationed right in front of the big human head, so which is a great place to find the gallery at. But what I do, I started making candles about 3 years ago. I make them in my home in Carmel, Indiana. And my degree was in art therapy. So I actually, this week has been a really awesome week. I am happy to say I'm a 4-year cancer survivor. So I celebrated that this week.
Congratulations.
My treatment, just making candles was really therapeutic for me. So I use soy wax, cotton wicks, everything's clean, natural ingredients. But I have lots of fun stuff that I do. So I have my standard candles that I pour. And then one of the things that I'm known for is I use a lot of luxury glass. So like this is a cloche candle. So just really cool glass that I use. And then with quarantine, people not being able to get out of their homes, one of the things I started doing was an at-home make your own soy candle at home kit.
That's great.
So one of the most fun things I've done is I pour in vintage glass too. So this is a vintage hen that I made into a candle. But I actually, today I premiered my my man candle, so this is a ammo can and I've made it into a candle. So it's my mandel and it's 3 pounds of wax. So, and it's been, I was at the Noblesville Farmers Market today and I sold out of them. So hugely popular for Father's Day.
Well, that is great. Congratulations first on the cancer surviving. That's unbelievable. And it's so great that you were able to utilize something that you already love to help you get through that. And now you're sharing that with residents and the community. It's wonderful. And it's art, it's candle, it's therapeutic. It's your work. It's handcrafted. It's really, really awesome. So congratulations.
Yeah.
Thank you for sharing.
One of the things I do, I work with a lot of foundations too, even local foundations. So like I'll do a candle for a cause. So I have a candle right now with Prevail out of Noblesville and I give back a percentage of sales.
Right.
So that's something that I really like to do too, is get involved with the community and give back. So.
Well, thank you so much for sharing it with us tonight here on the Carmel Virtual Meet Me on Main Experience. Susan, thank you as well to you.
Thank you.
We appreciate you taking us through the gallery. And we'll see you very, very soon in person, okay? All right, peace, Susan. Thank you so much.